His Home Secretary says the asylum system is broken. Who broke it?
Prime Minister.
Well, Mr. Speaker, we can look at the record on migration policy. Let's look at it. What did we on this side of the House do? We gave the British people a referendum on Brexit. Yes. We delivered Brexit. We ended the free movement of people, Mr. Speaker. That's our record on migration policy. It's not something the Honourable Gentleman supported. He opposed it at every turn, and it's not what the British people want.
No one wants open borders on this side of the House. They've lost control of the borders on their side of the House. Mr. Speaker, four Prime Ministers in 5 years, and it's the same old, same old. Yeah. He stands there and tries to pass the blame. Yeah. If the asylum system is broken, and his lot have been in power for 12 years, yeah, how can it be anyone's fault but theirs?
Yes, Mr. Speaker, people rightly want to see us getting a grip of migration in our borders. But look, let's look at the record. Let's look at the record. The Right Honourable Gentleman, he voted against the Nationality and Borders Bill. He said he would scrap the Rwanda partnership. He opposed the ending of free movement of people. Look, border control is a serious, complex issue. But not only does the party opposite not have a plan, they have opposed every single measure we have taken to solve the problem. You can't attack a plan if you don't have a plan.
We voted against it because we said it wouldn't work, and it hasn't worked. He says he's getting a grip, he's got a plan. So let's have a look at that plan. The Rwanda deal was launched in April. It cost the taxpayer £140 million and rising. The number of people deported to Rwanda is zero. Since then, 30,000 people have crossed the channel in small boats. It's not working, is it? He hasn't got a grip.
Mr. Speaker, we on this side of the House are clear that we want to defend our borders. When the Shadow Home Secretary this weekend was asked, she couldn't answer a simple question if the party opposite was in favour of higher or lower migration. It's that simple. The Home Secretary and I, when it comes to tackling our migration, reducing migration, we are on the same page. That party's policy, it's a blank page, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker, blame others, deflect, attack on something else. So much for the new age of accountability. Yeah. Of all the people who arrived in small boats last year, how many asylum claims have been processed?
Yeah. Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, we do need. Mr. Speaker, not enough is the answer, very straightforwardly. And that's what we're going to fix. But the honourable gentleman raises this question. What are we doing? We've increased the number of processing officials by 80%. We are putting an extra 500 more by next March. But if he really was serious about fixing this problem, then he would acknowledge that we do need to tackle the issue of people putting spurious claims. Spurious, repeated, last-minute claims to frustrate the process. That's how we'll tackle the system. So why, then, did he vote against the Nationality and Borders Act, which deals with it?
Mr. Speaker, he says not enough. You could say that again. It's 4%. 4% of people arriving in small boats last year had their asylum claim processed. According to the bookies, the Home Secretary has a better chance of becoming the next Tory leader than she has of processing an asylum claim in a year. And he talks about numbers. They're only taking half the number of asylum decisions that they used to. That's why the system is broken. 4,000 people at the Manston Air Force Base, massively overcrowded, all sorts of diseases breaking out. So, did the Home Secretary receive legal advice that she should move people out? Yes or no?
Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, The Right Honourable Gentleman is very fond of reminding us that he used to be the former Director of Public Prosecutions. So he knows the government's policy on commenting on legal advice. But what I can say is a significant action that the Home Secretary has taken to fix the issue. Since September, 30 more hotels with 4,500 new beds. Appointing a senior general to control the situation at Manston, and indeed increasing the number of staff there by almost a half, Mr. Speaker. These are significant steps to demonstrate that we are getting a grip of this system. But this is a serious and escalating problem. We will make sure that we control our borders, and we will always do it fairly and compassionately, because that's the right thing.
Mr. Speaker, he talks about my time as Director of Public Prosecutions. I prosecuted people smugglers. Yeah. He can't even get an asylum claim process. Yeah. I think the answer to the question whether the Home Secretary received legal advice to move people out of Marsden is yes. Yeah. He just hasn't got the guts to say it. Yeah. Weak. He did a grubby deal with her, yeah, putting her in charge of Britain's security just so he could dodge an election. Yeah, yeah. She's broken the ministerial code, lost control of a refugee centre and put our security at risk. Yeah, yeah, yeah. She did get one thing right. She finally admitted that the Tories have broken the asylum system. Yeah, yeah. Criminal gangs running amok, yep, thousands crossing the Channel in small boats every week, hardly any claims processed. Yep. So why doesn't he get a proper Home Secretary, yeah, scrap the Rwanda, yep, gimmick, crack down on smuggling gangs, end the small boat crossings, speed up asylum claims, yep, and agree an international deal on refugees? Start governing for once and get a grip.
Mr. Speaker, the right honourable gentleman.
Front rows, can we just calm it down a little? I do want to hear the replies. Covering your mouth's not helpful to me or you. Come on, Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, the right honourable gentleman rightly raised the topic of national security, because it is important. But this is the person who in 2019 told the BBC, and I quote, "I do think Jeremy Corbyn would make a great Prime Minister." Mr. Speaker, let's remember that national security agenda. Abolishing our armed forces, scrapping the nuclear deterrent, withdrawing from NATO, voting against every single anti-terror law we tried, befriending Hamas and Hezbollah. He may want to forget about it, but we will remind him of it every week.